Good afternoon, viewers. Today we have with us a multifaceted personality, Mr. Murugesh Nirani. He is currently the Minister of Mines and Geology in Karnataka and was formerly the Minister of Industries. He's an industrialist himself and is the largest producer of sugar in South India and also ethanol in South Asia. Mr. Nirani is with us today as part of the campaign that DH has been running over the past 2 weeks called Mayhem in Mines. We have been identifying several issues that are affecting people who are living around quarries and mines, and we'll be talking with the minister today. We are very thankful that you're here. First, we will start with one of the most devastating incidents that happened recently, that Shivamogga blast. Six people were killed in that incident. And like, there is an investigation was launched into the blast. What happened with the probes? Like, because nothing else came out of the probe after it was announced.
Last month in Shivamogga, it happened. When I taken the oath, same day, night 10:30.
Yes, sir.
It happened in the same day, about more than six numbers died. For that reason, more illegal explosive they brought from Andhra Pradesh. Through down here in Karnataka, so many checkposts they passed and they reached Shivamogga. It is unfortunate and seems very sorry to whatever happened. But already we've taken the action against them who supplied the explosive, then who transported the material illegally, how it came. Then everything is in investigation is going on. For them, six people, already we gave 5 lakh rupees for compensation. Then we are taking care of, should not re-happen in the other district and other place. Every check post and where they are supplying, where how they are bringing to the other district also, other than Shivamogga. After that, it will take time to control, but illegal explosives transportation was going on.
Yes, sir. Like, but don't you think these are like only reactions when an accident happens that the government takes? For instance, like yesterday, near the Muddyanapalle in Ramnagar, they are building bursting rocks near a village which has an orphanage, and one person was injured there also.
Correct.
And they say there is no permission for what explosives taken. So, like, how does it go under the...
What happens in the explosive? In Karnataka is not any controlled department.
Okay.
But only district collector is the authorized person. Whatever is it, he is taking the collecting all the information from that event, whatever the event happened in that place. They are recommended to the central government.
Okay.
Only police department is the only authority to investigation and all. Now slowly we are bringing it to the safer side. We are giving some training also. How to transport, how to keep it, how to use that one. Now we are giving the training to who they are using the explosive. We are taking care in future days, it should not happen in everywhere.
So what you're trying to say is this explosives are controlled by the central government and not by the state. So
Only this is authorized person. He is taking whatever the event happened.
Whenever the incident happens, he will take action.
He will report to the police department.
So, like now, is the police department looking into this supply of explosives? Because Home Minister had said that now they will keep a tab. Every 3 months, they will have explosive owners, will have explosive users.
That's how we are planning to do the training. Then, whoever is supplying the explosive, first we have to take the training to them also. It is required for the mining purpose. Now, whatever they are selling, they are marketing it, some procedure is there. They have to follow that procedure. Otherwise, this type of accident will happen.
So in Gangavati, sir, in the caves of Gangavati, there were some 3,000, 4,000-year-old paintings that of the Stone Age. So now they are quarrying in that location and many paintings are lost. So there were some 120 caves where there were paintings. Now it is very less. So is the government not doing anything to protect these ancient monuments of the state?
No. What happens in the World Heritage Centers, wherever it is there, so we are maintaining, we are not giving above 15 kilometers. Any explosive, the industry should not come there. It will happen, they have to collect the PPP at that micron level in the air pollution or the dust pollution or sound, like that vibration. Central government or Karnataka State Pollution Control Board, as well as Central Control Pollution Control Board, they're taking action against them to maintain the this what it is centers or wherever it is there.
Okay, so you're like you're taking measures to protect these monuments.
Yeah,
but still around Hampi there are still complaints that there is a lot of quarrying going on. Like, have you conducted any surveys in that region, or the department conducted?
No, I recently I taken the responsibility of this department. Every district I am planning to go very soon.
Hmm.
After that, wherever the this type of complaint will come,
hmm.
if it will come in the hospital, there is this one, Ballari or wherever it is, I'll take up all the district where the example. What heritage center? It is in the Badami Taluk, our district also.
Yes.
No, it's not. I am not waiting for the complaints from our district. Mm-hmm. Wherever it will come, we'll take care of all the district.
Okay. So one of the other issues which we highlighted is the gross underutilization of mineral funds. Like district mineral funds are collected, but they are not utilized at all. Even at places where it is utilized, people say it is not being put to good use.
Correct. I had taken the details.
Hmm.
Out of 2,600 crores, they utilized only plus or minus 700 crores so far.
Okay.
Still, we have 1,800 crore rupees surplus, unutilized money.
Mm-hmm.
That I give the instruction to the all over department and give the direction to the district collector also, where the funds is collected.
Hmm.
We have to utilize, we have to reuse there only.
Okay.
For mining reaptation.
Mm-hmm.
Then already it is a maximum amount you have to make the this one where we are using some guidelines is there.
Okay.
That purpose only we have to utilize that money. Maximum at least before March.
Okay.
We'll give the some shape in 2021-22, 100% we'll utilize this.
So like money. This 2,600 crores has been pending for how many years? Like this is the
last one or two years
you have corrected. Mm.
Some district, no, more than 1 year, they are not conducted the meeting also.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So, like you have identified these districts?
Yes. Already we made and we give the direction also. Immediately before March, they will make the this one, planning.
Okay.
That amount, where to utilize, how to utilize. Some guidelines is there. Based on that guidelines, they will prepare the report. Mm-hmm. Then at least we'll give the target within 1 year, they have to complete this one.
When you went to Delhi recently, you met with the Mines Minister Prahlad Joshi there.
Yes.
And you said that there were accumulated funds of nearly 18,000 crores,
yeah,
which were like fines and levies for iron ore companies. Hmm. And Supreme Court has like asked the government to come up with a proper plan so that they can allow the use of these funds. So what was the reason for this delay, Leo?
No, already it is a original amount is about 12,000 crores plus,
hmm,
including interest.
Hmm.
About near to 18,000 crores, it is a pending.
Okay.
Already we are preparing the DPR for 25,000 crores.
Mm-hmm.
This 18,000 crores interest, mm-hmm, first under accumulated income, everything. But whenever we'll give the direction that Supreme Court to us, mm-hmm, we cannot utilize this entire funds to overnight.
Okay.
Or within 1 year also.
Mm-hmm.
It will take 5 years to entire utilization of this 18,000 crores. That's why we are preparing the DPR 25,000 crores.
Mm-hmm.
In major, this is a beneficiaries, Ballari, Chitradurga, Tumkur, and some part of Bagalkot.
Okay.
Where the mining is there. For that only, for that purpose only, we are trying to go for the school of mining.
School
we are planning to open.
Okay.
Because whatever the, after mining, that area has to, we have to develop scientifically. We may start in the near to Ballari or middle Karnataka, where the mining is more. We are planning to start.
Okay.
In future days, after 5 years or some phase one, phase two, phase three, we are planning the school of mining. Then planning, ultimately, we are planning to go for the mining university. Also.
Mining university. Hmm. Okay. So, like, what will be the, like, for when you have the university there, what will be the benefit, like, after the area is exhausted of the mine?
So, that's why.
If you have a mining university there, who will
No, benefit? So far, they are not doing any scientific mining.
Hmm.
What they are going to haphazard manner, they are going for the mining. 1 acre, example. They may extract 1 lakh ton.
Mm.
If we'll go for the scientific way, in the same 1 acre land, we may extract more than 3 lakh.
Mm.
Like that, it is a 2 lakh rupees without touching the other area.
Mm.
We can extract more.
Mm.
Like that, we are planning to give the training to the whoever is going for the mining.
Mm. One more thing which concerns you is the sand issue in the state. There were proposals for a new sand policy, and as you know, government is also facing problems. getting sand for the construction of their own schools or Anganwadis in different parts of the state. So,
sand is an important item for the development of the state or country. Now, if you give the any project for construction of the road, building, government building, any other asremane, forest to poor people, that's why what I'm doing, in the poor people, whoever is taking the sand from two-wheeler or three-wheeler or from animals or bullock cart or a tractor, if they're utilizing that sand for their own use, not for trading, now we are planning to give to the free of cost, very nominal price, about 100 rupees or 20 rupees. That amount they will collect to the Gram Panchayat, local. If they will collect it in one place, in the stockyard, sand stockyard, then they are selling to the tipper or lorry. They are penalized and it's illegal. Then they will pay the royalty as well as penalty. Yeah.
So, like in those blocks, which is not allotted by the government, if someone is mining, you are increasing.
We are supportive to the poor people. Whoever is using this sand for their own use, not for trading.
Commercial.
No, we are supporting. See, in local Asare houses, it is very small amount we are giving from 2 lakh rupees, 3 lakh, 5 lakh, some different scheme. If they are paying about 50,000 rupees, 1 lakh rupees for sand only, how they will complete the building? Indirectly, if you will support them, if you're getting about 100 rupees, 200 rupees or 500 rupees per lorry sand to them, automatically they will complete the houses. It is, they will happy for the government. Nowadays also, that entire more revenue is not coming to the government in that sand, whatever we are selling.
It's illegally extended.
More illegal is going on. That's why whatever the that auction mining, for using in the roads, government building, trading, apartments, whatever is there, we are collecting the royalty and the penalty clause is there. Then whoever is using the forest to poor, their asremane, the farmers constructing the house, wherever it is, there are small houses. They can utilize that sand and not have to pay the high royalty.
Okay. One more thing that you announced recently was the single window clearance for mining purposes. Does it include for quarries also or just it includes for quarries?
Yes, it includes quarries also. It is this is mining department is not only the one single this one. Whoever is going to the mining, they have to take the clearance from the forest, ecology department, transportation, revenue. Like that, 8 to 10 departments they have to take the NOC. If they will go for the taking the NOC from all the department, it will take more time. That's why we will conduct the meeting in every district. Every once in a month. That is easy for them, whoever is going. It's a single window system. All the concerned head of the department in that district, they'll give the clearance.
Okay.
Like that, if it is a major project, every month they will conduct in the state level. Okay. If it is a mega project, our Honorable Chief Minister is the chairperson, they will clear the project.
But by giving this single window clearance for such projects which are not very helpful to the environment, so to speak, don't you think you are like encouraging?
No, whatever we are giving the clearance, it is within the legal framework only we are clearing. We are giving the direction like that only. Okay. We are bringing the new mining policy, accordingly they will clear.
Okay, this is for the new mines that will come up next. But what about the mines which are now, which are like not, they are legally sanctioned lands, but they are extracting it illegally, for example.
In central government, they gave the deemed extension. But they bifurcated minor mineral, major mineral, like that. Iron ore, limestone, gold, etc. It is coming under the major mineral. Before that, sand, the jelly crusher, everything it is coming under the minor mineral. What is our intention? If they are giving the 20 years lease, it is a deemed extension to save the time, should not harass the investors. That's why they extended from date of getting the license to some minor millers 20 to 30 years, some 50 years. Like that, it is a problem. It is a, they made the simplify the procedure. What happens if it is a deemed extension, then they are the legal. What they made once about 10 years back, that forest people gave the NOC. Now, 2 years back, they are giving the NOC. It is coming under our forest department. You close this one. Last 10 years, it is running the plant. They are paid the royalty. everything is on paper only. And all the statutory clearances they got from the East Department. Now they are issuing the letter. Now it is illegal. Now it is a surprise because that department only gave the NOC. Now they are giving the letter to close the mining. That is a problem. So, now we'll solve that one. That's why in this one.
Okay.
This mining adalat, whatever in the same district, whatever the issues is coming, and the different department will solve that.
One more thing that happened with this quarries was that there was a drone survey sanctioned in the past to assess whether how many quarries were legal, how many were illegal. Like for example, sir, at IAC conducted a survey in Chikbalapur, which identified more than 200 illegal quarries. So, but when this drone survey was conducted throughout the state, quarry owners went to court saying this drone survey is not right. So, how will government...
I'll also agree. Mm-hmm. Whatever they made the previous our department, that is drone survey, they're calculating the whatever they're doing the mining, multiply by the volume wise. They will take the volume. Then they will go for the royalty. But practically, that much quantity recovery is not coming. That yield is not coming there.
Yield is not low.
Some mines, 10% to 40%, it is varies. After drone survey, it will come 100%. Then they will multiply by the 5 times penalty. It is in scientific.
Okay.
Then, whatever we are telling, yes. That's why practically, if you go and see the mining area, that's why it is a problem. We'll find out the way how to assess the after getting the volume from drone survey. We'll finalize, we'll reduce the 5 times the penalty.
Okay. Mm-hmm. One more thing, we have a question from one Srinidhi. I think he's from somewhere near Malappuram Basin. Sir, he says, what measures are the government is planning to take to curb illegal sand mining in Malappuram Basin? Because environmentalists are demanding that sand mining in Patta land should be controlled in that basin, but it is going on.
Not only Malappuram, this problem is all over the Karnataka. Mm. Not only Karnataka, it is all over the country also. Mm. That's why we are bringing the new mining policy.
Mm.
Already I told from two-wheeler to up to tractor, bullock cars, we are planning to give very nominal price.
At a nominal.
Very nominal price. Whoever is going for the trading and whoever is taking the sand from lorry, tipper, like that, for the commercial use they are using. It's the same is there. We'll bring the new policy as well as with legally...
When is this policy going to
come? Very soon. Already they started the work.
Okay.
We are taking the feedback from the other neighboring state also. Mm-hmm. And whatever the problem facing in the within the district.
Mm-hmm.
Already I called all the mine association also. Now I am collecting and we'll go for the new mining policy. Before announcing the policy, the draft will circulate to the few people that association. Okay. It should not affect the revenue as well as it has to give easily available the sand to the end user.
Okay. Yes, sir. Well, one more question we are having is from one person from Chikbalapur's Bhagyapalli. His name is Narasimhamurthy. He says that there are dry lands, like for Chikbalapur Jille, Bhagyapalli Taluku, Dashakagalindalu, Barapatti in the Horabartilla. Igagle Atiachu Nirina Samasya, Fluoride, Ityadi Rudrinda, Idru Kalganikarikena Martyre. Water, we are facing problems for water supply and issues. So what is the measures government is taking to prevent illegal quarrying in it, especially these dry regions?
So really mining anthro madlebeko. Mining madodrinda, nam development work continued. Mine maadlarade sand, metal, irlardene nam construction work aagudilla. Construction means road irbodu, government building, private building, own houses, so ittadi ee bandaga nam sand metal iddagane agutte adakke avu impact nam nature mele enagutade avaru yenu question kelidare adana innu sub deep ag study maadi ellella anta problem bartade adanna senior geologist athwa expert kadidinda report thondu yav yav area dalli maadbeku maadbardu anthadanna ಒಂದು ಆಳವಾಗಿ ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದ್ರ ಮುಂದೆ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ತಗೋತೀವಿ. ಇಷ್ಟು ಮಾತ್ರ ಸತ್ಯ, ಮೈನ್ ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಅದು ಲೀಗಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್.
ರಾಮ್ ಫೇಸ್ಬುಕ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಕೇಳಿದೆ ಸರ್. ಸೇವ್ಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ಕ್ವಾರಿ ಆರ್ ಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಅಡಿಷನಲ್ ಚೀಫ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟರಿ MSMA ಅಂಡ್ ಮೈನ್ಸ್ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಸಿನ್ಸ್ 4 ಮಂತ್ಸ್. please give strict instructions to officers.
ಇಲ್ಲ ಅದು ನನ್ನ ಗಮನಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದಿದೆ ಸೇವ್ಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಬಂದಿದೆ ಅದ್ರ ಸಲುವಾಗಿನೇ ನಾವು ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಬಂದ ಮೇಲೆ ಇವತ್ತು ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ 1 ಮಂತ್ ಆಯ್ತು 1 ಮಂತ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ತರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಅದಾಲತ್ ಅನ್ನೋಂಥ ಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಅದಾಲತ್ತು ಆ ಡಿವಿಜನ್ ವೈಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಆಫೀಸರ್ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂತವೆಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಆಫೀಸರು ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿನರ್ ಕೊಡೋ ತೊಂದರೆನೂ ತಪ್ಪಿದೆ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೇವ್ಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ನಾವು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಮಾಡೋಂಥ ಕಡೆ ಗಮನ ಹರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ವಿದಿನ್ 3 ಮಂತ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಒಂದು ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ 10 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಟು ಸಮ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಮೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್ ಯು ವರ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಇಂಡಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದ ಕ್ಯಾಬಿನೆಟ್ ಇನ್ 2008 ಬಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಕಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟ್ರಗಲ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಬಿನೆಟ್
ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸೀಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ಬಿಜೆಪಿ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಐ ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ 50% ವಿ ಗೇವ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ದ ಹೂವರ್ ಇಸ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ other party to BJP. That's why the percentage is less. Whoever has not got the opportunity in last 2008, we gave it to them. That's why I waited. But I have not got the ministry. But I proven my efficiency in the this corona time also. I started six units. I started. I gave more than 10,000 employment in 2020.
During the lockdown.
You see in the Mandya Mysore side, one is Pandopura SSK cooperative factory, then Sri Rama, like that in Badami Sugars, Kedarnath Sugars, then Ranna Sugars, then MRN Cane Power. Like that, I started about 6 sugar factory and distillery and cogeneration.
During the period when
you're
not minister?
No, if I got the ministry, we are doing the public work here. If I'm not getting, I'll do the other work. It's very simple.
Like now, your community is demanding 2A reservation. Reservation, right? 2A categories. Like before,
yes.
Yeah. So, like one of the CS who is spearheading this campaign is Mr. Vachanandu Swamy, who had like even like sort of dared Yediyurappa last year, saying that you should make Nirani minister or else Panchamsali community will leave you. Today, and
sir,
then
what
one series that way. The other is Mr. Jayamruthyunjaya Swamy, who was also in this agitation where they demanded separate Lingayat religion. Now, these two CS have joined hands and are now demanding 2A reservation for Panchamsali.
Correct. In our 6.5 crores population in Karnataka, out of that 80 lakhs is a Nirsav Lingayat Panchamsali. Out of 80 lakhs, more than 90% all are coming from the agriculture family. They are uneducated. Most of the Panchamsali is uneducated. They are doing the farming. That's why they are suffering the government facilities in the job or this education, job and education. Our Panchamsali is not asking all the category. For political reservation, they are not asking. Only two they are asking. Already some other our Lingayat community, they got it. But now we are comparatively them. We are very poor. We are staying in the village. We are staying in the field. That's why at least you can give them one education facilities and another one is the job facilities.
So what one of the things that we are hearing in this Panchamsali agitation was, like you were the first persons who encouraged these Swamijis to demand this reservation. Because
no, it is
because
not today's and yesterday is this one.
Yeah, but you
this
had
is going on last 25 years. Last 25 years, other our senior leaders, like Kashyap Naur, he was a state president. Then he was a minister. Their government was there. That time also they tried. And it's continuous process, not today or yesterday.
So it's not because Mr. Hirani was not made minister of Panchamsali.
No. It's not like that. Our Yediyurappa ji, he's the first person to support Panchamsali Lingayat. Our Lingayat Panchamsali is not in the any community list. Jati kalamdalli irleilla.
Okay.
ಅದನ್ನ 2A ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ 2008 ಮೇಲೆ ರೆಫರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ವಿ ಮೇಡ್ ದ ಒನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಬಿನೆಟ್ ಸಬ್ ಕಮಿಟಿ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಕಮಿಟಿ ವಿ ಮೇಡ್ ವಿ ರೆಕಮೆಂಡೆಡ್ ಟು ದಿ 2A ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಸಮ್ ಲೀಗಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ವಿ ಗೇವ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು 3B ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ 2A ವಾಸ್ ದ ಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್
ಓಕೆ
2010 ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಸ್ಟರ್ಡೇ ಆರ್ ಟುಡೇ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ up to 3B already Yediyurappa is only he made. Now 2A is also he I think he's studying after getting the report. he will take the proper and good decision.
Don't you think this will reflect badly on the government? Because like earlier, Panchamsalis were all considered total as Lingayats only. Now they want distinct identity apart from Lingayats. You want to throw your weight around saying these are these two.
No, we have my so many intention is also no. My intention is also whoever is economically poor. All the their demands as per their economically weaker section, everybody has to get this reservation. It's my own view. That's when the reselling guys also so many subcaste is there. If they are giving also, everybody is getting the 2A also, I mean.
So like if now say Okaligas, which are like who are not like not all of them are poor, I think. Yeah, Okaligas demand reservation and all other communities demand reservation. Can the government fulfill?
Already Okaligas got the reservation long back only. Yeah. When Devegowda was the Prime Minister and Chief Minister, already they are in the they got the category.
Okay. Now they're still demanding for more. Like there is demand, there demand from Okaligas, there is demand for more. From Valmiki community, there is demand for more.
No, Valmiki, I'll tell you. Already central government gave the 7.5%. Already they announced the political reservation in the central government. Only in the state they are asking job and education. Already central government, nobody will question it. Already they announced. Then already some studies is going on. Then the Halmata Kurva community is also asking they want to join ST. Already Hindurida Ayoga.
Backward class.
Backward class commission. Or Jay Prakash Reddy is the president. Now they are studying all over the state. Then they will submit the report. Or Honorable Chief Minister and our cabinet will take the decision after submitting the report.
One more thing. Like again, Vyatnad Basangoda Patil will feature in all discussions until this government is here. Because he has been accused like attacking the government day in, day out. But why is no like say prominent figure from the government stepping out and defending the government from Vyatnad's allegations? Like for instance, yesterday he said Vijayendra financed Congress and RJD in Bihar elections.
No, what I'm telling, he's a senior person. He's a MLA, MLC, MP, he was a central minister, a senior person. Whatever he has to discuss in the any problems, he has discussed in the party forum within four walls. If they are talking with the outside, I'm too young to tell to them. It is not good.
But still, doesn't it cause embarrassment to the government? Like, doesn't it reflect badly on the government?
That's why already our senior central and the proper they will take the already they issue the notice. Already he gave the reply also.
After the reply he said this, like when if he is so brave to make all these remarks in the open, do you think someone is supporting him from the national leadership?
Nobody will support like this. No, it is a damaging to not only the Yeddyurappa's and family, it is damaging to the party also. Nobody will support it. I don't think so.
So, like there was this unhappiness over Yeddyurappa's rule, Yeddyurappa's leadership in Karnataka. With like there were indications that the leadership will change. What do you see make of that?
Like, no, Yeddyurappa already our central high command is announced. Yeddyurappa will over the next 2.5 years, this period complete period will be the chief minister. He's this one. Paksha ido.
Government is what?
Ivare continue agirtare mundina election osse tavu
Arun Singh
avaru Arun Singh avaru idare innu senior leaders nu helidare
okay
nam rajyadhyaksaru helidare avare mundina avadiginu avare mukhyamantri irtare baruvanta varshalinu osse tavu leaders alline chunavane hogutide matte avaru helidare mundina chunavalli 150 kintala hechu seatana gathukon bartive anuntide matte he is a mass leader.
Yes, ಈಗ ನೋಡಿ ಸರ್, ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ಆಗಸ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಟೈಮಿಂದ ಆಗಸ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಡಿಸ್ಕಂಟಿಲ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತು, ರೆಬೆಲಿಯನ್ ಆಗೋತರ ಇತ್ತು, ಕ್ಯಾಬಿನೆಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪಾಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಡಿಮಾಂಡ್ ಇದ್ರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸಡನ್ ಆಗಿ ಜಾನ್ವರಿಲಿ ಮೊನ್ನೆ ಅವ್ರದ್ದು ಚೇಂಜ್, ಡಿಸೆಂಬರ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಅಂತ ಆದ್ರೂ ಏನು ಆಗದೆ ಜಾನ್ವರಿಲಿ ಹೋದಾಗ ಎಲ್ಲ ಲೀಡರ್ಸ್ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಮೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಕ್ಯಾಬಿನೆಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪಾಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಒಪ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರ. ಹಿಂದೆ ಯಾಕೆ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಅಷ್ಟು ಅರ್ಜೆಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ? ಜಾನ್ವರಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾಕೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಅರ್ಜೆಂಟ್?
ಮಧ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಗೃಹ ಸಚಿವರಾಗಿರುವಂತ ಅಮಿತ್ ಶಾ ಅವ್ರದ್ದು ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಸರಿ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೈ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಇತ್ತು, ಈ ರೀತಿ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಅವ್ರು ಮಾಡಿರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಇವರು ಐವತ್ತೈದು ವರ್ಷದಿಂದ ಐದಾರು ದಶಕಗಳಿಂದನೇ ಅವರು ಚುನಾವಣೆ ಇದು ರಾಜಕಾರಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅವ್ರು ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಅನುಭವಗಳಿದೆ, ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಫೋನ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಕ್ಲಿಯರೆನ್ಸ್ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀಸನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ಅವರು ಕ್ಲಿಯರೆನ್ಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟ ಮೇಲೇನೆ ಇದನ್ನ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪಾನ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿರುವಂಥದ್ದು, ಅವ್ರ ಪರ್ಮಿಷನ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಅವ್ರ ಗಮನಕ್ಕಂದೇ ಮಾಡಿರುವಂಥದ್ದು. ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ನಮ್ಗೇನು ಇದು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೀಡರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಉದ್ಭವ ಆಗುದಿಲ್ಲ, ಅವರೇ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ.
ಓಕೆ, ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಸರ್. ಈಗ ನೀವು ಈಗ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದೂವರೆ ತಿಂಗಳ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಬಂದಿದೆ, ಏನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಥಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಪ್ಲಾನಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್
ಸರ್? ನಮ್ಮ ಇಲಾಖೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಟ್ಟಿ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮೈನ್,
ಓಕೆ,
ಅದನ್ನ ಮಾಡರ್ನೈಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪಾನ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಅದನ್ನ 2 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಒಯ್ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದಿದೆ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ದು ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಟಿವ್ ಪವರ್, ನಮ್ದೇ ಸ್ವಂತ ಆಗಿರುವಂತ ಪವರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಅದನ್ನ ಬಳಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಾಗ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಸರ್ಪ್ಲಸ್ ರಿಸರ್ವ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಅದು ನಮ್ಗೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ನಂತರ ಇದನ್ನ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ವಿಂಡೋ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ತರುವಂತದ್ದು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅದಾಲತ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡುವಂತದ್ದು, ನಂತರ ನ್ಯೂ ಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಲಿಸಿ ತರುವಂತದ್ದು, ಈ ರೀತಿ ಇನ್ನೂ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ರೆವಿನ್ಯೂ ನಮ್ಮ ಇಲಾಖೆಗೆ ಬರುವಂತದ್ದು, ಈ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡುವಂತದ್ದು, ನಂತರ ಈ ಇಲ್ಲಿಗಲ್ ಆಗಿರುವಂತಹ ಮೈನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಲೀಗಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡುವಂತದ್ದು, ಅಕ್ರಮ ಸಕ್ರಮ ನಾಟ್ ಫಾರ್ 100%, ಎಲ್ಲಾನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿರತ್ತಲ್ಲ ನಾವು. ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಆ ಚೌಕಟ್ಟದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರ್ಯಾರು ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಲೀಗಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡುವಂತದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಗಮನ ಹರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ. ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಕಡು ಬಡವರಿಗೆ, ಆಸರೆ ಮನೆ ಕಟ್ಟುವಂತವ್ರಿಗೆ, ಟ್ರೇಡಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಲಾರ್ದೇ ಸ್ವಂತ ಉಪಯೋಗ ಮಾಡುವಂತವ್ರಿಗೆ ಕಡಿಮೆ ದರದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗುವಂತದ್ರ ಕಡೆ ಗಮನ ಹರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ. ಈಗ ಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಸೇವ್ಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಕಡೆ ಗಮನ ಹರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ. ಈಗ ಮೈನ್ಗಳು ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ಬಂದಿದೆ, ಕಾನೂನಿನ ಚೌಕಟ್ಟಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲ್ ಟೆಂಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅವುಗಳನ್ನ ಎಚ್ಚರಿಕೆ ಮಾಡಿ ರೆವಿನ್ಯೂ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಮಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದು, ಉದ್ಯೋಗಗಳನ್ನ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿಗೆ ಸೃಷ್ಟಿ ಮಾಡಿಸುವಂತ ಕಡೆ ಗಮನ ಹರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ. ಈ ರೀತಿ ಇದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೇನೆ ಇದು COVID-19 ಹೋದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಮುಂದಿನ ವರ್ಷ, ಒಂದು ವರ್ಷದ ನಂತರ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ನಾವು ಗ್ಲೋಬಲ್ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಮೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ, ಅದೇ ತರನಾಗಿ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲ್ ನಾವು ಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಮೀಟ್ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಚರ್ಚೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ, ವಿಚಾರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಅದ್ರ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಗಳ ಗಮನಕ್ಕೆ ಮತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಕ್ಯಾಬಿನೆಟ್ ಚರ್ಚೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿ ಒಪ್ಪಿಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ರೆ ಒಂದ್ ವರ್ಷ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅದನ್ನ ಪ್ರಿಪರೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಟೈಮ್ ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಅನ್ನೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ಪಟ್ಟಾಗ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಬರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇದೆ. ಅದನ್ನೇ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಕಡೆ ಡೇಟ್ ಅನೌನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಇದು ಬಜೆಟ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ಮುಗಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಅವ್ರ ಗಮನಕ್ಕೆ ತಂದು ಅದನ್ನ ಅನೌನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಒಂದು ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ದಲ್ಲಿ ಗೊತ್ತೇನ ಅದನ್ನ ನೋಡುವಂತ ದೃಷ್ಟಿ ಇದೆ, ಇದೇನು ಕರಪ್ಷನ್ ಇದು ಎಲ್ಲಾನು ಏನಿದೆ, ಅದೊಂದು ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ಒಂದು ಸುಸಜ್ಜಿತವಾಗಿ ಈ ಇಲಾಖೆಯನ್ನ ಮುಂದುವರಿಸಿಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗೋ ಕಡೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬದಲಾವಣೆಗಳನ್ನ ತರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ.
That's it, viewers. We had our minister with us talking about all the measures he's planning to curb illegal practices in the state. He has also some visions regarding setting up of a university so that there is more scientific mining or scientific extraction of these natural resources in the near future. He'll be holding mining adalats to address some of the concerns. And he has assured to look into all the violations that many quarries and mines are doing throughout the state. Thank you for being with us, sir. Thank you for coming here and putting up your views. Thank you very much.